I pray that as the word goes forth this morning, that someone will be blessed, that someone will be encouraged, and that the word will not return void. The word of God says, as the snow and the rain comes down from heaven and stays on the earth and cause the earth to bud and to bring forth, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. So is the word of God. When it is sent forth, it shall not return void. Father, we thank you for your word. We break the bread of life right now as your word goes forth. We thank you that your hungry people would feast upon your word this morning and be filled. We thank you for God, for Joy Gospel Radio. We thank you for blessing this radio station exponentially in 2020. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. So quick, we want to turn our attention to Luke chapter 13 and verse 6 through 9. And it says, he spake also this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came and sought fig thereon and found none. Then said he unto the dresser of his vineyard, behold, these 3 years I come seeking fruit on this fig tree, and from none, cut it down. Why cumbereth it the ground? And he answering said unto him, Lord, let it alone this year also, till I shall dig around it and dug it. And if it bear fruit, well, and if not, then after that thou shalt cut it down. Thanks be to God for the reading of his holy word. As we dissect this quick word, the first question that comes to mind is, why is a fig tree in a vineyard? If we understand what a vineyard is and not an orchard, then we'd understand the reason why we ask this question. And to find out what a vineyard is, we go to the dictionary. And Dictionary Online defines a vineyard as a plantation of grapes, especially where grapevines are produced or for production. And that answers the question as to why is a fig tree in a vineyard. It should just be vines and grapes that are in this place. Now, as we look at a vineyard and vining, and those of us who are into farming, and I have just gotten into farming in the last few months, since this lockdown is therapeutic, and it is also rewarding to when it's time for us to pluck and harvest from those seeds. So I have planted some tomatoes, and I've planted some peppers, and I've even planted a grapevine. And one of the things that I realized is that it is good to have these things trellis. It's good to have these things staked up. And to stake these things up, you would need to have some form of stick, or some people would use the tomato cage or whatever. So this fig tree got in the vineyard first as a stake, first as a simple piece of stick to support the vine. It got in there to be a supporter. It got in there to help as a helper. It did not get in there as a tree, as a seed. No, the function and the intent of the dresser was for it to simply just sit there dormant and just hold up the vine. But it decided to put on roots, because when the situation is right, the obvious and the natural is inevitable. So it got planted in the soil. And we would just say life just happens. As it got planted, it put on some roots and it began to sprout and brought on its leaves, and eventually it was considered a tree. Now the dresser did not ask it to be a tree. The dresser simply asked it to sit there. Do not take up my soil. Do not take up my nitrogen. Do not take up my potassium, do not take up my phosphorus and my other, you know, trace minerals. Just simply sit there as a tree. But again, as I said, the inevitable would happen when the situation is there for it to happen. There's nothing else to do, but the tree will put on roots when it is planted. This text is especially for those of us who are going through some very hard times right now. We are in a situation, or we're in a crisis, we're in circumstances where we did not choose the ones that we are in, but life happens. No one chose for COVID-19 to come around. And because of all of that, jobs lost. We know that if we do not have a job, we cannot pay our bills. So we have bills that are mounting up. We didn't choose to be sick. Some people are sick right now, and they're back and forth at the doctor. They did not choose to be sick. Someone may have a child that is pregnant right now out of wedlock. You didn't choose that. But we are in life at this time. And because we are in life, I put that in a bracket, the inevitable will happen. The things that we are not able to avoid will happen. And when those things happen, what do we do? Irregardless of the vineyard dresser is looking for fruits, because there is a tree that is capable of bearing in this vineyard. It did not choose to be there. It could not have even chosen how it got there, but it is there. We cannot choose, and we did not choose how we get where we are, but we are where we are, and we still have life in our body. And the word of God is saying to all of us, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Even when you're sick, still praise the Lord. Even when you cannot pay the bill, still praise the Lord. He is still expecting praise to come out of us. He is still expecting some worship to come out of us. He called the mountain, he called the trees, and I don't know if I gave you this text the last time was when I was here, but it is one of those texts that is becoming almost as an anthem, which is found in Isaiah 44 and verse 23. And it says, shout, O heaven, for the Lord has done it. Sing ye your low parts of the earth. Break forth into singing your low parts of the earth. And it's asking to mount the mountains also to rejoice, and the forest and every tree that is in it. For he's still our Redeemer. He is still the one who delights to delight himself in man. So my quick word to all of us this morning, though we did not choose and could not have chosen how we get where we are, again, with the sickness that is in our body, with the pain that is in our body, with all of our brokenness, with the ridicule, you know, the tree might have been ridiculed by the grapevine. The grapevine might have considered the tree as a weed because it was where it should not have been. But you know, as I said, I am becoming a farmer, and yesterday I was cutting down my ground, and I have a wonderful, you know, example for this word this morning. And as I was weeding up, I came across this particular tree. And for the longest of while, I've been looking at farmers' videos on YouTube, and they would bring up this tree that is called ground cherry. You know, in the Caribbean, in our garden, we have this tree that we have been cutting down time after time and thinking that it is weed. It is actually a fruit. If you Google ground cherry, you'll realize that you have cut down this tree many times, loaded with fruits. And when I came across this tree, I said, but wait, this seems to be the ground cherry. And as I've said, it is a tree that I've cut down so many times before. Now it is loaded, and I'm fully aware of what it is. And now I know it is not a weed. It is a fruit tree, and it is loaded with the fruits. It is a fruit that is loaded with vitamins and, very nutritious. But yet, I have been considering it as a wheat all these times. So you may be considered as a wheat, I'm sorry, as a weed by everyone else around you. You may be considered as no good But God is seeing that there's something great that he has placed in you. And by all means, you must live out the destiny that is on your life. COVID-19 or no COVID-19, there is still a call upon your life. There's still ministry. There's still worship. There's still praise that is in you that must come out in this season. So I'm encouraging you, my listeners, to not give up and not give in. But this is the season and this is the time. The word of God in 1 Corinthians and verse 10 and 13 tell us, they have no temptation taking us, but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who would not allow us to be tempted that above which we are able, but he will with every temptation provide a way of escape. So yes, you are in a strange place. You are even in a place where others may hope to be. It might be a once in a lifetime opportunity, the trial that you are going through, for God to bring forth something greater through you. I remember in 1995, a great sickness came upon me for an entire 9 months. And it was through that sickness that God birthed forth the ministry of healing and deliverance, because it drove me deeper into my prayer room. It sent me on my knees. It caused me to know God in a new way. It was one of the first times that I experienced God as Jehovah Shalom, because I heard of him and I read of him and I said of him many times that he was Jehovah Shalom. But I never knew what it was like to experience God that way. And also in 2011, I went through one of the hardest times in my life with the breaking up of my marriage. And it was a hard time. I was in a hard place and I could not see how I could have continued to worship this God that would have allowed my family to break up after I had given him so many times of my life, after I'd spent so many times in prayer. But it was his doing. He did it, and I had to say, nevertheless. And he presented himself as Jehovah Shalom. How could I have known that he was Jehovah Shalom unless I had a time when there was no peace? I am encouraging you, my listeners, this morning to get to know God in a new way in the season that you are in. Don't just keep hearing him being said. Don't just keep hearing it being said that he is Jehovah Shalom. And never get to experience him as Jehovah Shalom for yourself, as Jehovah Jireh, and not get to experience him with a testimony that he's indeed Jehovah Shalom, that he's in Jehovah Rapha. That's what I was looking for. That he's your healer. Unless you were sick, how could you know that he is your healer? So I leave you with this quick word this morning, that wherever you're planted, you need to grow. And as you grow, you would bring forth fruit that is worthy to be served to others, so that others can eat the fruits of the suffering that you went through with the testimony that comes with it. I bless God this morning. I know it is a quick word and I do not want to keep you any longer. I pray that you get the word this morning, that though you may be considered a weed, because you're not where others thought that you should be, you are going to bear fruits right here. That when he comes back, he is going to find fruits on you. Sickness or no sickness, drought or no drought, famine or no famine, sing or barren, thou that didst not bear, break forth into singing. Enlarge the place of your tent. Stretch forth the curtains of your habitation. Lengthen your cords. Strengthen your stake. You shall break forth on the right hand and on the left hand. For your maker, your husband, he is the Redeemer. He's the Holy One of Israel. The Lord has called you, and you cannot be refused in this season. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen.